What's up, boxing fans? This is Andrew to do another boxing analysis. This analysis is between Keith One Time Thurman, and I'm telling you guys, Keith One Time Thurman versus Leonard Bundu is gonna be an amazing fight. Leonard Bundu from Florence, Italy. I'm telling you, my G, it's gonna be something special. It's a very good fight. You know, Keith Thurman undefeated, 23 wins, 21 knockouts, KOs for life. You know, KO lifestyle. Keith Thurman, I call him, you know, the Seminole Black Kid. You know, the Afro Native American roots with long braids. I just really think that he's gonna do work in this fight. He's gonna show people why he's elite, why he's one of the best pound for pound in the sport today. And a lot of people doubt him. They say he ain't shit. Say he talk too much shit because he got his new slogan called "Burn Money," and all "Burn Money" means is he's looking for Floyd 2015. He's calling him out. And he only has two fights left on his contract. So Keith Thurman, you know, he has the skills to pay the bill. He can fight inside, fight outside. He's very strong. He used to fight at 152 in the amateur, so he can get up and weight if need be. It's his natural weight to be at 147, and he doesn't struggle to make it. He's very focused, very intelligent boxer puncher. He has a great jab. He controls very well with his jab, and he uses angles and lands great shots from the outside. And he can jump in the inside at any moment and set you up with his jab or his lead right hand and come with left uppercut like he hit Jesus Soto Caraz and knocked him out. And Keith Thurman's always in great condition. You'll never catch Keith Thurman not in condition. That's not like Ben Gedi talking about. Leonard Bundu, on the other hand, he's a hooker. He likes to throw hooks. His biggest punch is his left hook. If he lands his left hook, he can give Keith Thurman problems. He has really good uppercuts at times, too. I've seen some of his fights. He's an Olympian. He was, I think, an amateur for over 15, 13 years, something like that. He's been around for a while. He's 40 years old. 31 wins, no losses, 2 draws, 11 knockouts. And I really think he's going to give Keith Thurman a solid stiff test. Keith Thurman has a good right uppercut as well, jab right uppercut. He even throws a right hook to the body that's really, really clean and it's really, really accurate. Key to victory for each. Bundu, come in like a Marcos Maidana type, pressure, cut off the ring. Use your jab to do so and land body shots while he's sitting on the ropes and try to get him tired and then start landing a looping overhand right that you throw pretty well and throw your money punch, your signature as a left hook. The keys to victory for Keith Thurman, and Bundu has to win by knockout if he doesn't throw 100 or 80 punches per round and land a good percentage of them. Keith Thurman, be Keith Thurman. Use your jab, be intelligent, move around the ring, give him different looks, show him different angles, straight right hand leads, jumping left hooks, check left hooks, straight right hand feint, left uppercut, finish with a left hook. If Keith Thurman throws combinations, he can get him out of there early. If he decides to pot shot, take a little bit longer, but I believe his straight right hand to the body and stab jab will break down Bundu, and Keith Thurman will win by, I'll say, 7th round knockout, because Bundu seems like a pretty sturdy dude. He's not called the Lion for a reason, and he's going to try his best to win because he doesn't want to lose his O. Somebody's O has got to go. And Keith Thurman is known for facing guys who are undefeated. It's time to step up for Keith Thurman, and he wants those big fights. It's up to Al Haymon and his team to get him those fights, so don't give him so much slack. And like I said, control is everything in boxing. I will always say that in all my videos. If you can control your opponent, it's been proven 95% of the time you will win the fight. So control is everything. Keith Thurman controls his opponent, controls the pace, controls the ring with ring generalship, gets into his head psychologically and controls him in a mental aspect. It's all over. I want to see Keith Thurman do this. We put both hands behind his back and watch his opponent go down. I think that's brilliant. Because he is going to get a knockdown in this fight. I believe it's going to be by probably a left hook or a left uppercut. But anyways, like I said, you guys tell me what you think in the comment section below. 7th round TKO stoppage, or even a big knockout for Keith, one time Thurman. Oyate, washing out yapping.